It's news time. Information is power. The current. The news headline. Bishop, God told me there will be a United Igbo Republic. A Inewi-based preacher has prophesied the emergence of what he called a United Igbo Republic amid growing calls for separatism in Nigeria's southeast. Bishop Abraham Chris Ude, the General Overseer of Mount Zion Faith Global Liberation Ministries, aka Fire by Fire, in Inewi, Anambra, said he had received the revelation while observing his ministry annual 40-day prayer and fasting that a group called Indigenous People of Biafra is poised to actualize the new republic. Bishop Ude told the media that those to make up the new Igbo nation, as revealed to him, would consist of Igbo-speaking inhabitants of rivers, Edo, Benue, Akwa Ibom, Delta, and all other states with Igbo speakers. According to him, this new development is better than sticking to Biafra. The name Biafra should be dropped to embrace the new name. The Igbo must zero on the United Igbo Republic, Igbo Bu Igbo, and a new group called the Indigenous People of Igbo, IPI, are the ones God had designated to actualize Igbo new nation. You should know that Indigos are Republicans. The agitators must stick to this new God's agenda, and the new name will add tonic to Igbo freedom without wasting time. People from Ishekiri, Ijo, and some parts of Bayelsa have moved themselves from the struggle, and they should not be left alone. They have been brought over by the Fulanis. If any of them is later interested, they can apply to the United Nations for inclusion. But by the way, United Nations is doing bidding of the Islamic nations. They should not be trusted. United Nations organization has lost its credibility. The organization should be known now as United Arab Nations, UAN, and not UNO, because of the activities ongoing supporting Islamic nations. If Igbo inhabitants in Rivers are added to the new republic, the Igbos would not be landlocked, as some uninformed antagonists of Igbo have thought. People from Ikwere in Rivers and those from Ika Igbo are free to join this movement that must come to pass. Others can go ahead with one Nigeria. The United Nations and Nigerian government must not waste time to conduct a referendum to make sure these revelations come to pass. Nobody can change it. Igbo are destined to have the new republic, and nobody can stop it. The Nigerian government has failed to declare bandits and killersmen as terrorists, only to insist that IPOB as an organization seeking freedom is one. This cannot continue, thus says the Lord.
The lawyer Ejiofor Ifeanyi is of the opinion and has stated that the federal government cannot prosecute Kanu for the radio, for his talks on Radio Biafra, because the court lacks the requisite jurisdiction to entertain saying, because the amended charge saying that he, you know, in the amended charge of the 7-count charge saying that his words that were said on Radio Biafra has been monitored in Enugu and some other part of Nigeria, that he said some words that can actually incite war and the likes like that. And the lawyer says that all these things that are said, that they were just basic elements, because Mazen Nnamdi Kanu himself was not physically, there, to carry out all those allegations that were said against him, and that all these things that you were saying, that it is even annulled just because they abducted him from Kenya and consequently extraordinarily rendered him to Nigeria without first subjecting him to extradition proceedings in Kenya, and therefore there is no case against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. This is as in the same line with his lawyer in the UK, Bruce Fain, who had also taken up the matter to the United Nations Human Rights, United Nations Human Rights High Commissioner.
Kanu's denial of right to counsel after detention, with time and facilities necessary to prepare a defense, is arbitrary and a violation of Article 14, subsection 2B of the ICCPR. Nnamdi Kanu has been tortured by the Federal Republic of Nigeria in violation of the Convention Against Torture by a detention in solitary confinement coupled with denial of necessary medical care to treat his heart condition. The violation makes his continued detention arbitrary under Article 9 of the UDHR and Article 9, Subsection 1 of the ICCPR, the lawyer declared. Fain further averred that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's detention is additionally arbitrary because a significant motivation is that the federal government's opposition to his political opinions, protected by Article 19 of the UDHR, Article 19 of the ICCPR, Kanu's detention is further arbitrary because significantly, if not excluding on his ethnicity as a Biafran, in violation of Article 2 of the UDHR and Article 2 of the ICCPR. And these were the words of Bruce Fain, who happens to be the legal counsel of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu in the UK, you know, and he has dragged the Nigerian government to the United Nations office, you know, that the federal government of Nigeria are actually stampeding on Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's fundamental rights because they extraordinarily brought him to Kenya from Kenya, you know, brought him to Nigeria, which does not, you know, go in line with the international laws. And, you know, on June 19, 2021, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu was present in Kenya and he was kidnapped at the Jomo Kenyatta International Airport yet there in Kenya. And he was detained and tortured for approximately 10 days before he was subjected to extraordinary rendition, where he was brought to Abuja in Nigeria on or about June 29, 2021, without either a judicial or administrative body. He added that so Bruce Fain has took them to court, that is the United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights, you know, demanding for the immediate release and quashing of all offenses by the federal government, because the federal government has no basis to keep detaining Mazi Nnamdi Kanu at the at the DSS facility, claiming that even people that were his lawyers that he was supposed to be able to see at the specific times so that they can prepare very well for his release, that the lawyers were being denied their writing materials into whenever visiting Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, and it's not possible for them to cram all the tactics, you know, and the methods and strategies as wanted by their client, you know, without any writing materials. And he also included that when he also visited on September on how to discuss with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu on the ways a man has to approach this case internationally, he was actually denied access to see Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. That was on September 2nd and 6th, 2021. And Fain maintained that for the fact that they can be, because what they are saying is that they are charging Mazi Nnamdi Kanu for treasonable felony, that he's using his Radio Biafra to incite war. And the lawyer insisted that nothing of such happened because everything he has done does not insinuate or incite war against Nigeria, saying that, therefore, that it is even the federal government that had, extraordinarily rendered Mazi Nnamdi Kanu from Kenya to Nigeria, and therefore they cannot benefit from their own wrongdoing. Thanks for listening.